Before 9/11, I was a Canadian, like anyone else. Yes, I looked different and I dressed different, and there were curiosity about that, but I was still part of Canada. Post 9/11, I have become the other, and so has my community. We are constantly defending, we are constantly explaining, we are constantly trying to prove our Canadianness, whatever that means. And that is a burden that we carry, and I guess perhaps, like one of my friends, Rabbi, told me, he said, this is your turn. Every community in Canada has gone through this. However, I do question, and I think we must question, now that I'm a grandmother and a third generation of my family is Canadian. My outlook has changed from just attacking and just questioning to actually being part of the change. And that is very important for us to know. When people complain about what's happening from the powers to be, and I was questioned in one of the classes at the university, and you know how this government, that government is doing and so forth. And I turned to them and I said, how many of you voted in the last elections? Only two hands went up. So it's easy perhaps sometimes to look, as I said, I was the other, looking at the other and saying what was wrong. But I think as citizens, we need to get involved. I think what brought to my attention after 9/11 was that I was a citizen of this country. I chose to be part of this country, to adopt this country as my home, and the responsibility also laid on my shoulders. Of course, do not excuse what's going on. And I see that post 9/11, the first interview that I had, and I think Donald was interviewing us, was this right away a red flag went up in my head, because suddenly the evil side of Islam was mentioned. And I'm sitting there saying, okay, versus what? Evil side of Christianity and Judaism? And it's so quickly, the whole scenario was framed in the context of religion that it really kind of shook me. And then slowly and gradually, if you see the progression from that point onwards, because for some it was a very good way to address their own concerns by saying, look, you guys are now victim of Islam. Well, we have been for the last 60 years of the Muslim terrorist, right? So it became a context that they could now play up about what they were experiencing in their country. The second thing that I noticed was from the feminist perspective, and I don't put all the feminists in one basket, but from a certain very vocal part of the feminist group was suddenly about this Muslim woman who's oppressed, repressed, oppressed, and depressed, and how she needed to be, and a mindless creature who needed to be told what was good for her without being asked. The third was from the media, which suddenly was chest thumping of how we believed in freedom of expression, as long as that expression valued what you valued, but dare not question what you value. And now they had a villain, and so somebody to beat up with, and somebody to put up, you know, and have these sensational stories about. The fourth area that I found there was a lot of giddiness in was the so-called social activists who were suddenly. Because remember, when we say activist, we are not saying that all activists have this very, I mean, there are activists on the left, on the right, on the, everywhere, with their own agendas. And so we had this Sharia tribunal, faith-based tribunal discussion in Ontario, which went crazy and out of hand. and everybody was trying to outdo each other as to who could bash Islam the strongest and the bestest. And that was people from within the community, but nobody was asking, well, what is Sharia? Everybody became an expert. So an industry grew around 9/11, the anti-Islam, anti-Muslim industry. So if today you want to be popular, if you want to be the best writer or just write something against Islam and Muslims. And this is it. It will guarantee your success. Nobody will ask you how your grammar is, how your composition is, how good a writer you are, as long as that is. So it was quite an awakening call for myself and my community. Not to say that things are not bad in so-called Muslim countries, or that some people interpret Islam the extreme way, or that there is a lot of debate and critique that needs to take care. However, if it is done in the context where there is very little information and that the information is really misinformation, when it is seen as fashionable, it is seen as acceptable, when our ministers can stand up and say, anybody who is, Muslims and Arab organizations that are critical of Israel, their funding will be cut. And we all remain quiet as to, it's Muslims, that's fine. When sessions are held in Winnipeg that talk about developing human intelligence, and when our first respondents are trained by ex-CIA agents who tell them how to profile Muslims, what questionnaires to ask, and is attended by 200 of our police and our hydro and our EMTs, and the one who brings it to the attention of the authorities, an editorial is put in the Winnipeg Free Press, which is myself, naming myself as somebody who's brought a frivolous complaint against them. And you think, like, what the heck is going on? When booklets are being distributed on the streets of Winnipeg, free of charge, talking about all the ills of Islam and how Islam is there and Muslims are there to kill everyone and how they're anti-Canadian, anti-democracy, and you name it, and you bring it to the attention of the police and the Department of Justice, which comes around and tells you that it's very stupidly written. It's not a work of an intelligent person, so it doesn't really pose a danger. Okay? So I guess all that happened in Rwanda with all those stupid people going on radio and calling the cockroaches and so forth, or what happened in other times of history, because they were stupid, we didn't take them seriously. But we know the result of it. So I think when Leslie and my other friends were talking about being conscious of what is going around you, to be asking the questions, because I don't have the answers. I can just point you to what is happening, the change that is taking place. It is very subtle. Mr. Obama's administration just said, we are not going to review what happened in the time of Mr. Bush's administration. We are going to move forward. How are you going to move forward unless you know what happened and how systemically it has already penetrated all through the justice and all kinds of systems? And that is my concern again here, is that if we are not conscious of what has systemically penetrated already, the anti-Muslim, the anti-Islam, the anti-dissent, attitude within our justice system, within our policing system, within our political system, our educational system, our social systems, how are we going to correct and move forward? So what can we do? My guess is as good as yours. I ask you, most of you know more than I, is how do we really bring back or perhaps charter a new course I usually tell people is that I'm not concerned with whether you agree with my faith or not, whether you agree with my choices, but you must stand up for my choices, because that's what Canada is about. And so we can have a debate and we can disagree, but if we do not stand up for each other, unfortunately, we are headed for trouble. Thank you.